The FCC has set a $35 fee for amateur radio licenses and for GMRS licenses, and we're going to talk about that right now.
Shut up and sit down.
Hey folks, welcome to the channel. My name is Jason, I'm KC5HWB. On this video series, we do reviews, news, and how-tos of many things that are new in amateur radio, and this is definitely news, and it is new both, okay? So a while back in August, the FCC proposed a $50 fee for amateur radio licenses, and through a lot of different signed petitions and arguments, I mean, so, you know, ARRL got involved, of course. Through all of that, they finally came to a point where they said, okay, we're not going to charge you $50 for your license. We're going to charge you $35 for your license. And the $35 fee includes new licenses, renewals of licenses after 10 years, vanity call signs to change your call sign, and it includes upgrades. If you go to from technician to general, general to extra, you pay a $35 fee. And the $35 license is good for 10 years. 10 years, that's $3.50 a year for a ham radio license. So it's not too bad in my opinion. Let's take a look at a couple of different websites that I found. The first one, of course, is KB6NU. This is the first place I saw it. Dan Romanchek, he's been on this, on a previous video of mine in the past. We've done some interviews with him. He's a good dude. He runs a podcast himself, very heavy into CW. He has kb6nu.com as a blog that he keeps up with. And he writes in here, in a report order, FCC 20-184, the FCC has set the amateur radio license fee at $35. It includes quite a bit of commentary on how it decided that amount. In the R&O, they noted, we agree with customers asserting this fee is too high to account for the minimal staff involvement in these applications and therefore adopt a reduced amount of $35 fee for all personal license applications fees. They also addressed some other concerns brought up by the nearly 4,000 people who commented on the amateur radio license fee. For example, they write, numerous commenters suggested that amateur radio licenses should be exempt or are exempt under Section 8 Delta 1 of the Act. We disagree and note as a starting point that the Commission has no authority to create an exemption where none presently exists. Thus, if an exemption exists, it must be continued within the wording of Section 8 Delta 1 of Act 61. None of the listed exemptions apply to exempt amateur radio service fees. So Dan goes on to write, basically what they're saying is that since Congress did not specify exempt amateur radio, not specifically exempt amateur radio, they cannot do it on their own. The FCC also disagreed with the argument that the amateur radio service should be exempt for fees because amateur radio operators provide emergency public communications. This is a long paragraph here. And Dan responds to it in this wording down here. They also address the argument that it would discourage younger people and others who may not be able to afford the fee entertaining the hobby. ARRL and many individual commenters additionally claim that the proposed fee will harm the public interest by discouraging people who are younger from becoming licensed or by causing people who are older and living on a fixed income to leave the service, depriving others of their skills and experience. These commenters explain that participation in the amateur radio service can be an entry point to science, technology, engineering, and math careers. They also note that amateur radio licenses have driven innovation in communications and other technologies. While we agree that participation in the amateur radio service offers important public interest benefits, that determination does not alter our obligation to, under RABOM's Act, to adopt cost-based fees for processing applications regarding to non-exempt service. So he goes on to write about this more and more, and then of course he links it down at the bottom. So, quite frankly, you know, I'm not sure that I care. Do I actually care that we've enjoyed a free license from the FCC for years and years and years? Not since I have been licensed in 1994 have I ever paid for a license, other than the testing fees that some VECs charge. So do I care that it's $35 a year? I'm sorry, $35 a license, $35 for 10 years, $3.50 a year? I don't think I care about that. Now, I don't want to see that increase. You know, I don't want them to come out with some stimulus in 5 years or 10 years that doubles or triples that amount, of course. But Overall, is it going to affect what I do? No, not really. The other part that I found is on By2Way Radio's website. Of course, they are a sponsor of the show, so I keep a look on their website pretty regularly as it is. And it says, the FCC has approved new license fees for amateur radio and GMRS. These fees are actually lower than the original proposed fees in August, which were highly contested by hams but welcomed by GMRS licensees. While the new FCC license fees may alleviate some of the sticker shock from the original fees proposed by the commission, it is welcomed news for fans of GMRS. Now, I think what they mean by that is not that the GMRS fans were happy that hams were getting charged. I think they were saying they're happy because the fees to get a GMRS license have now been reduced. So they added a fee to ham radio licenses where none existed before, and they reduced the fee from $70 for 10 years to $35 for 10 years for GMRS license holders. I personally I had a ham radio license for years and years, but I also have a GMRS license, and I paid $70 for the first 10 years of my GMRS license, and now, in fact, I just renewed it like a year ago, and now it's only going to cost me $35 for a 10-year GMRS license also. We're going to have some videos comparing ham radio and GMRS upcoming on this channel very soon. So you might say, well, why don't I just get a GMRS license? It's the same price as ham radio, and I don't have to study and take a test. I just have to sign my name, pay $35, and I have a call sign. True, but you don't get as much. Not nearly as much. A lot less. My suggestion is to do both. And we're going to talk about that in another upcoming video. But on By2Way Radios, they go on to state, according to the FCC, an order released December 29, 2020, amateur radio license fees will now cost $35. This same fee will apply to new licenses, renewals, vanity call signs, and license modifications. Again, modifications are if you change your address. So you move out of state, move across the city, you change your mailing address, you have to modify your license on the FCC ULS, and which is then transferred to QRZ. A lot of guys I know, they don't like their home address being on the FCC ULS, so they'll get a post office box or a private mailbox. That's a modification. You can change it from that to that. You can change it to a private mailbox, to a PO box if you move out of state, something like that. If you want to change your name, that's a modification to the license. So that's just one example of what the $35 fee will be added to if you want to modify the license. Previously, no fees were collected for ham licenses or vanity call signs issued to amateur radio operators, so technically this is a significant change. However, it is considerably less than the $50 fees originally proposed by the commission, so it should be of some comfort to hams. I don't think $35 is considerably less than $50. In fact, it's only 30% less. The proposal was $50, and they made it, when they actually enabled it, they made it $35 instead of $15. So they reduced it by 30%. $15 is 30% of $50. I wouldn't call that a significant change. In fact, I would call it a more significant change that they went from $0 to $35 for a 10-year license for hams. That's a much more significant change than significantly less from $50 to $35. You might disagree. Some people may, yeah, that's semantics. That's just, you know, that's an opinion. That's true. But somebody wrote this article. It's an opinion there is not. So I don't think it's significantly less, $35 over $50, but it is less. So that's, you know, it's not as much. So that's a good thing. On a brighter side, a GMRS license will now cost significantly less than before. That significantly I agree with, because used to be a GMRS license was $70 for 10 years. You just filled out the form, signed your name, paid your $70, and boom, you got your call sign and GMRS privileges on one band, the 440 band, the UHF band, I should say. It's actually around 460. So you get one band, you get access to repeaters, you get access to up to 50 watts on FM only. Okay, so now that license will cost you $35 for 10 years instead of $70 for 10 years. So that is a significant decrease. I agree with that statement right there. With this report and order, the new GMRS license fees will be only $35, which is $15 less than the proposed fee and half the cost of the fees previously charged by FCC. The license is still valid for 10 years and covers an entire family. You can go on to read. They wrote quite a bit. Good article on this right here. They quote a lot of the same stuff Dan writes. And, of course, they link to the article below, to the actual FCC document below, just the same way Dan does. So what do you guys think? Good, bad, right, wrong? Put your comments below. I'd like to know your thoughts on this fee proposal. I personally don't have a problem with it. I don't. I think it's fine. I think I don't think it's going to affect anything I do. It's certainly not going to affect this channel. But I'm interested to see what you have to say. So put a comment below. Let me know your thoughts, and we'll catch you next time.